Hi, I'm Gail Locke McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. Today, I want you to picture a little kid running up the steps. He jumps one step, two steps, or three steps at a time. How many paths up the steps are there?
So picture this child at the bottom of a big 100-step staircase. The very first decision he makes is, how many steps in my first leap? Well, if we picture all the paths up 100 steps, the number of paths up 100 steps is the number of paths up 100 steps if he jumps one step in the first leap, plus number of paths if he jumps two steps in the first leap, plus number of paths if he jumps three steps at the first leap. So let's consider one of those options. Number of paths, how many paths are there up 100 steps if he jumps three steps at the first leap? Well, that's going to be equal, you know, the only choice once we've jumped three steps up, then we just have to figure out, well, how many steps are there up 97 steps? So we can break that down recursively like that. So I'll fill in my base cases a little bit later, but what we can say here is number of paths up 100 steps is each of those options. So it's the number of paths up up 99 steps plus the number of paths up 98 steps plus number of paths up 97 steps. Now, what about my base cases? Well, if the number of steps is negative, then zero, then there's no paths. What if there's zero steps up? So we're currently at the top step. Well, you could kind of define this either way. I'm gonna argue it should be one because if we're already at the top staircase, there's one path and it's staying right there. But you could also argue it's one or it's zero. But it's kind of up to you. This is going to be really, really inefficient. It's going to be somewhere close to O of 3 to the n because there's three different branches we go out at every single recursive call. So that's going to get super, super slow. So I'm going to rename this to count paths R. And I'm going to try to tackle this with a memoization approach. So we can do, I'll actually copy and paste this so you can keep this existing code live. And I'm gonna call this count paths memo. And it's gonna notice that basically we're repeating work. We compute count paths of 65 multiple times because there's gonna be a bunch of ways to get up to the 65th step. And then once we get to the 65th step, no matter how we got there, it's the same number of paths up the remaining steps. So we don't need to repeat this work. So what we should be doing is saying, compute this, or if rather, so it's a lot like Fibonacci. So if memo of n is zero, if we haven't computed this yet, then compute it. Compute this. So memo of n is that, and then return memo of n. And I also need to pass in this memo table. Now, it's always nice to give the caller some function that wraps this because this so they don't have to figure out what the right parameters here to call it should be. So I'm gonna give this count path memo steps. And this is just gonna be a simple wrapper function that immediately goes and calls this other function. And what I need here is that I need this memo table to actually be bigger than the number of steps because I actually want to store memo of n in it. Okay, so that's the memoization approach. It's dramatically faster. This is going to give us a linear time approach, whereas the other one was exponential. So a lot faster, but it does take O of n space. We can also tackle this iteratively in sort of a dynamic programming approach. So I'm going to call this dynamic programming, and I no longer need memo table here. And what I want to do here is just create this table, and it's going to be called paths. And it's going to be, we need one bigger than the total number of spots. I'm going to need to return or set the initial value. So paths of 0 is going to be 0, paths of 1 is going to be 1, paths of 2 is going to be 2. Then I just need a simple for loop. 4 into I equals 0. Actually, this should start at 3. For I equals 0, I less than or equal to steps, I plus plus. And this should compute this just for paths of, let me start here. This should compute this for paths of I equals the sum of the last three values. Paths of I minus 1 plus paths of I minus 2 plus paths of I minus 3. And then I return paths of steps. Oops, I just noticed a little issue here. That should say that, not n. All right, so note here in this count paths DP, I'm leaving this code in, and the reason why is that imagine I call this for steps of say 2, then or say steps of say 1. What's gonna happen here, in fact, I need to make this even bigger. I need to say if this is less than or equal to 1. Because what could happen here is imagine I pass this in with steps of 1. Well, then I'm going to create this integer array of size 2, and then this will get an array index out of bounds exception. So I want to actually check for these two cases explicitly. Now this is still going to be O of n time and O of n space. So although we've cut out the stack space from the recursion, we still have this memo table that takes up space. But if you think about what this paths table does, we don't need all the values there at all times. We only actually need the last three values. So our final approach takes advantage of that. So what it does is, I'm actually just going to copy and paste this and fix it up. So I'm going to call this count paths of I for iterative. And what it's going to do is I only need an array of three values in here. So this is going to start off with being 1, 1, and 2. And then the next value is going to be the sum of the last three values of paths. So paths of 2 plus paths of 1 plus paths of 0. Then I need to shift paths around. So paths is going to be, because I only need the last three values at all times. So paths of 1 or paths of 0 is going to drop off completely and just become paths of 1. Paths of 1 is going to become paths of 2. And paths of 2 is going to become this new count. Then at the very end, I just return paths of 2. And just for completeness sake, I'm just going to add a little bit of extra validation code. So if steps is 0 or is negative, then I'll return 0 here. Otherwise, I'll just do the fallback on the recursion. And then notice I have a little issue here. That should have been steps. And I copy and pasted, so I got the same bug twice. Okay, so three different approaches to doing basically the same problem. Four different approaches. So different level efficiencies, and one builds off the next. Now, in an interview, what you'll probably do is not implement four different solutions. You might implement the recursive approach and then fall into the fix up and go to the memoization approach. Maybe you would actually implement more than one, but you know, I wouldn't start off with the approach of I'm going to implement all four things because that's going to just give you too much work to do. But do be very, very careful in any recursive problem to watch out to make sure your base cases are correct, because that's a really common error. And then also think about the efficiency of your recursive approaches and see if there, particularly if you wind up in an exponential situation, see if there's some sort of repeated subproblems you could take advantage of, because memoization approaches come up a lot in interviews. So those are the final tips I have for you. Good luck.